And now?
Ejection systolic. Soft.
By hook or by crook, we get there in the end.
Well, looks like you've just gone on someone's Christmas list, provided you can deliver.
Serious thing.
Mrs. Douglas?
Hi, enjoying the tour?
Mr. Owen has carotid stenosis. I need to schedule an endarterectomy.
Not a problem. Phil Jameson's our top vascular guy, but even he can't do it from Verbier. I can get Sarah to give Prof. Kev a call.
For today's list? I shall perform the procedure before Mr. Owen's bypass.
Thing is, that's not how we usually do things around here. I'm sure Kev
I've
Burden...
made my decision. Inform theatre, please.
In that case, I will let them know.
Good. Thank you.
Thank you. All of you. For everything. Don't worry. I'll give Penny the good news. Unless, of course, you want to. Draw a line under everything. I'll talk to her.
Good afternoon, Miss Beecham.
Oh, you are kidding me. I have seen the future, and it is edible cake and personal elevators.
Michael! Great timing. I had a cancellation, so I'm all yours. At least for the next 45 minutes.
Great, let's do it.
Oh, Connie, about your list today. Little bird tells me you're planning an extra procedure, an endarterectomy.
Those little birds sure do move fast.
If it's okay with you, I'm going to give Kev Burnand a call, just the way we tend to handle things here.
Oh, I can assure you, I'm more than capable.
Of course. There's a certain protocol, and this is a vascular case.
Granted, but my patient...
We'll have the very best. We can email Kevin the scans now. If he agrees, we can find him some theatre time as soon as he's available. I'm sure you agree. But I hear it was a great spot. Egg in Mark Banner's face, eh? Shall we?
Definitely.
Good afternoon, Miss Beecham.
Oh, shut up!
Hey, I can't stay. Did you get the echo results?
Yeah, fine. All clear. I'm giving my marching orders.
That's great. Okay, I've got to go.
And I wanted
about
to talk
you said.
To you.
You first.
I was out of order. The Spain thing, I shouldn't have asked you like that.
What was he saying?
What we had was great. Amazing. I got caught up. I guess I just needed someone.
And now?
I just want to forget about it. The hospitals, tests, I just want my life back to how it used to be.
Are you saying that I took advantage of you?
God, no, it was my fault. I should have been stronger. I should have coped alone. I let you risk everything for me, and that wasn't fair. It wasn't right. I'm scared that if you come with me, then all I'll see is a bad memory.
No, don't. You don't. You just go.
I'm just curious the board would let someone like Connie go. Not without putting up a fight.
Well, maybe they did.
I heard different. Chief execs talk too.
There's nothing to tell. Connie didn't feel valued, so she decided to walk. End of.
No little shove?
No, not to my knowledge. She just wanted to go. Come on, who can blame her? Maybe she just wanted a lifestyle upgrade.
Doesn't strike me as the type. I've got a few here, believe me.
All right. Look, if you want my take on it, strictly off the record.
Sure.
Connie's old school. Been brought up in it. All that Marcus Welby jazz. She likes to rule the roost. No question, no debate.
Times change.
Unlike surgeons, huh? So, we gonna talk business?
My favorite subject.
All right.
That should have been three.
Thanks. You know, when I told Scott that I wanted to leave with him, I had this weird feeling inside. And do you know what it was? Happiness. And I didn't even recognize it. Because it's been so long since I felt anything even remotely like that. I was going to Spain with the man that I love and... You heard that, didn't you?
You'd really do it. You'd give it all up for him because there's no way back.
Maybe I just don't love this the way that you do.
You trust him? Look, Ben, when Scott and I went down for the echo, we may have had a little chat about your career and about how he has to be damn sure about his feelings for you before he makes any kind of decision.
So you're delaying it?
This way you receive the optimum care.
So why change your mind? First we're all set and then suddenly we're seeing this prof guy tomorrow?
Sorry. Excuse me.
Do you want to be with me? Just say it, yes or no.
You've got a life here, a career.
I can get new ones. You didn't answer my question. Yes or no?
Yes. Shouldn't you get that? That.
But...
Get it, I can wait.
It's not possible.
Look, if I square things with Vanessa...
She suspended me.
Surely, if I explain the situation...
Elliot, you have done this procedure before. You don't need me.
But you have by far the greater experience.
Rachel, she trusts you?
She's consented.
Come on, this is Rachel Jacobs. She understands the risks. Do you really think she would agree to this if there was any shadow of a doubt in her mind?
She accepts me, but she wants you.
I'm sorry, Elliot, but... I mean, under the circumstances, there's nothing I can do.
Sorry, Elliot, I need to take this. Right, pain, how long?
Honestly, on and off all day. Worse for the last hour, I'll be good.
Let's get you into theatre. You get the anaesthetist down here and tell Theatre One we're on our way. Now? All right, I just need to listen to your chest. Try and relax.
She slapped me.
Did it hurt?
Well, I wasn't ready. But yeah. So,
how does it feel to be ruining someone's life?
Oh, you tell me.
I'm protecting her.
And I'm in love with her.
No, too easy. You don't get to do that. You don't get to drop the L-bomb and ride off into the sunset. She has a life. Here.
Yeah, a life that she hates. A job that she can't stand. And a brother who spends so much time protecting her that I don't think he can see what's staring him in the face.
This is what she wants?
I think so.
No. Not good enough, you better be sure. In fact, you better be damn sure you know what you're doing.
You're smiling, Dr. Valentine.
Am I? I'm sorry.
You'll be assisting Mr. Hope today. Or perhaps you have more pressing matters to attend to.
Oh, Mr. Byrne.
You should see this procedure. You may not get another chance.
It's really not my decision.
But you want to be a surgeon. It's a funny thing. You believe you choose the way your life goes, but sometimes it chooses you.
I know what I want. Could you just give us a moment?
I had a friend once. A very good friend. She looked a lot like you, around the eyes. We parted. I had to think of my career. We weren't conventional. You understand? I had no choice. Because this had already chosen me. Come to theatre. Observe. Daydream if you must. Come, please.
I will.
Thank you.
You're doing the carotid?
Yes, is there a problem?
Not with me.
Good.
So, where do you want me?
Out of my theatre. Oh, the staff here may vouch for your many admirable qualities, Mr. Douglas, but I value loyalty. I can still see you.
You're the boss.
Turn that off. Knife.
Dr. Green?
Happy as a sendboy, Mr. H.
Okay, we're just about ready for the graft. Could you let Mr. Byrne know, please?
Damn, got to bleed. Bloody things like Swiss cheese.
Three up,
okay, we are ready to do bypass, so if you'd get the perfusionist in, please.
Are you a little less happy now, Mr. G?
Cross climb, please.
Do you ever fancy a change of scene?
Do not tempt me.
Allow me.
Good afternoon, Mr. Kyriakos.
I love that thing.
Mr. Kyriakos, it's about Miss Beecham.
So, how is theatre?
Unremarkable. Why?
I understand there was a complication. Mr. Owen.
He developed further chest pains, and in the circumstances, I've held immediate surgery.
Dr. Banner, he concurred.
It was a clinical decision.
Which you should have run by our cardiologist.
I think I'm more than capable of deciding where my patient needs urgent surgery.
And the endarterectomy.
Mr. Owen received the optimal treatment at the correct time.
You came here with a reputation. The committee had doubts, but I overruled them.
I am the best you've got.
That is the only reason I won. There are no kingdoms here, Ms. Beecham. No little princes or princesses, just a group of professionals working together.
To make money.
You're really that naive. What did you think this was about? It may surprise you, but I don't need great surgeons. I just need people I can work with.
Like Greg Douglas.
Why not? Rock the boat and there are 20 guys just like him waiting to take your place in a heartbeat.
Hey, just wanted to say so long. I'm not interrupting anything, am I?
I think I've made my point.